I have like two fans on in here and I'm starting to sweat. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin. And today we're listening to Camel with their songs, finishing out their album, actually, The Snow Goose, Epitaph, Fritha Alone, La Princesse Perdue, and The Great Marsh. This is off of the album, like I said, The Snow Goose, released in 1975. This has been a really fun and interesting adventure of an album to go on and listen to. And even though I've broken the songs on the album up into different pieces and everything, like, once you listen to it as a whole, as I have before getting to this point... Was that a helicopter or a motorcycle? It's a fun little journey to go on, and the album is really strong. I'm enjoying it. So let's finish it out. I don't have much to say, except I hope that you're having a great day. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments below. And before we go on our adventure, don't forget to like and subscribe. I don't know why I came up with this song. Let's do it. This is Epitaph through the ending of the album. Let's just go. What am I doing? Thank you.
Okay. How cool was that reprisal at the end? How absolutely face-melting was that reprisal at the end? As I was listening to it, I was like, this sounds like really familiar, but I can't quite place it yet. You know, I haven't listened to the album that many times to quite get it just yet. But then, like, as soon as it went into that, as soon as it hit that and the drums changes its groove, I was like, oh, we have heard this before. How smart was it to reprise it the way that they did? So cool. To me, that's kind of like one of the best things about reprisals when they're done right, is it makes you remember like those parts that you've heard before. Even if you haven't memorized the song or you're not 100% familiar with the song, your brain usually catches things that maybe you didn't quite notice on the first listen. So when it hit that point, I was like, oh, that is how you make music satisfying for the listener to listen to. As always, and as expected, great work from the whole band. To me, especially, of course, Latimer. He kind of always stands out to me. And especially Barden's. He gets a little solo in the song before, over here in Fritha, alone, I believe it was. Yeah. But this is a really nice way of coming back in. Actually, going to Epitaph, Epitaph and then leading into Fritha Alone was a really nice way of coming down off of Dunkirk and slowly rebuilding that energy and that momentum. Of course, powering everything down and then charging it back up as it got into the Princesse Perdue, or La Princesse Perdue? La Princesa? La Princesse Perdue? And even this is kind of familiar. You get some church bells in the back ringing out as it kind of brings everything back down from the more momentous Dunkirk. But then I really like this piano that opens up Fritha Alone. This is just very rich. This is a very gorgeous way of bringing it all in. And then pulling it up just a little bit further. Even in this transitional piece between the big come down in Epitaph and what's coming up next with Perdue, very fitting, you know? And that's one thing I do like about Camel specifically in this album, is everything that they've done feels very fitting for the story that they're trying to tell. Even though it's instrumental, it all works in giving you a sense of setting, character, and plot progression. And coming into Perdue with the strings coming in now, these violins providing this really nice orchestral rise. We get Mr. Bedford helping on that with the arrangement itself. And I like how it just grows in intensity. Like, you know that this is going to be that climax that you're looking for out of the album. Because the last song is just a retread of where we began. But this is cool. Listen to how well the bass and the drumming fits with the orchestra. I think that's really nice. That's really good. And then, of course, like I said, Barden's. He's rocking out here. Eventually, Latimer rocks out here as well. Yeah, when he hit this, I was like, man, this feels so familiar. But I couldn't quite place it at the time. But this time you get a little bit of the strings in the back, breathing a new life into this piece. That's really good. And of course, that powerful drumming. But here's the moment where it clicks. Right here. Hits every time. It hits every single time. That is so gorgeously done. That was really nice. And like I said, it ends once again in a reprise of The Great Marsh, the very first track that we began the album on. And also in Epitaph, just going back really quick, we also had some sound effects that sounded like the beating of a bird's wings. Apparently that's Doug Ferguson, who's playing the bass. Apparently that's him beating a duffel coat or something. Because I always saw that in the instruments and I was like, what kind of instrument is a duffel coat? And I guess that's exactly what it was used for, to give that kind of sound effect of the birds flapping their wings, or the goose flapping its wings. Anyways, what a brilliant end to the album. What a really, really feel-good ending to the album. As always, I would love to know what you guys thought of it. You can join me on Twitter, join me in the comments down below. Thank you so much for following me on my journey through this album. I hope that you guys enjoyed it as much as I have. Have a fantastic day, guys. That's all I gotta say. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.